RootsMagic has a to-do list on steroids. And today I am super excited to talk to you about how to create tasks in RootsMagic. So here we are in RootsMagic. And in order to get to the tasks, this tasks icon and click on that. And then it will open up a window where you're going to have all of your tasks. In a new database, you're not going to have very many. In the first window, you will be able to see the folders that you can assign tasks to. Now, one of the things I like about this folder thing is that you can add tasks to multiple folders, and multiple folders can have multiple tasks. So let's say that you're going to be researching in a land record, and that land record can answer the question of who were John Townley's parents, and you could put it in that folder. You could also put it in the folder of who were the children of Effingham Townley. And you can put it in that folder. So that one task of looking at land records can go to two different research projects, research questions, if you will. And you can put all of the tasks in those folders, but only enter them one time in RootsMagic. If you have any questions about that, if that's not very clear, make sure you write a question in the box below. Now the next window, it's called the tasks window. And this window is really great because it's where all your tasks are managed. So we're gonna slide all the way over. And here is the information about the task. So let's go ahead and walk through adding our first task. But before I do that, I wanna give you a little insight. You see these little bars here, if you get the arrow that goes left and right, you can resize your windows. So maybe you want your folder panel a little bit smaller. Maybe you want the task panel a little bit larger. Slide it to the right. There you go. So I just took this handle and I slid it to the right, and then I can move the priority to the right. I wish it was easier to do the sliders, you know, that I wish I could do this one and this one, move it left to right instead of the way I showed you. But if you don't like the sizes of your bars there, you can drag and drop it there. So that's a little trick, but that doesn't tell you how to start creating your first task. All you have to do is click on Add New Task. Now, as you can see right here, I need a birth record for Helen Teller. What is the next reasonable record that I would want for Helen Teller? Well, that would be a marriage record. So there's several ways that I can type this in. I could say marriage record. I could get rid of this and put MC for marriage certificate. I can also say that I want to look on family search. FS for family search. I can do ANC for ancestry. There's other options. I've seen people put in the word open. I guess that means that it's an open research project, but with the priority status and the check mark for complete, I'm not necessarily a fan of that. Now, another situation where you might want to put in a task might be like reminder information that eventually you want to have in a research log, or just reminder information for your overall project. For instance, when did Colorado begin keeping civil registrations of marriage records? So in this sidebar here, we could do marriage certificate for Helen Teller. Or we could just do marriage certificates for Colorado and then put in a reminder, began in question mark. And that way, whenever you find the information, that task stays in your database as a reminder. Oh, if I'm researching in Colorado before that date, there won't necessarily be a marriage record for the couple I'm trying to research. So utilize these tasks not only as to-do list, but also research reminders as you find them. You're basically building a research guide, a locality guide into your tasks. The next thing you're going to want to do is add dates to your project. You can put a start date, the last time you worked on it, and then a final date. You'll be able to sort these later. What I really like about this is you can actually create a calendar. So I'm making this video on January 15th, so I can just grab that. Now, if you're converting a research log to a task and you're in the middle of it, you can go ahead and switch the years and then switch the months and then go ahead and pick a date. You can also do a drop down that way for the months if you would prefer. Click select and now you have a date, and you can do that for each one. So let's say you ended the date today. Click the 15th and select, and now you have an end date. Now the task goes in your goals/details. Now here is an example of a goal. And you might be thinking, wait, isn't that what you already have in the title? Well, you would be correct. I have the task, the description, marriage record, marriage MC for Colorado. Let's actually convert that back. The difference is the name is going to be on your side of your task collections. If you generate a to-do list printout, or if you eventually create a research log, the description, the goal/details, that is what's actually going to appear on those printouts. So you're gonna do something quick and even use some abbreviations, however that works best for you behind the scenes. And you're gonna put that in the name field. But for the goal/details, you can put in what you want to look for. So you can keep it brief. It could be just marriage record for Helen Teller. You can also be more lengthy in your goal/description. Now the next field is for when you've actually accomplished your task. So when you have an end date, I've accomplished my task, or maybe you're in the middle of your research, then you want to go ahead and use your results. My results thus far, my results at the end, whichever works, go ahead and click on this arrow to the right and a pop-up screen will appear. Do you ever have a time when you have a not in location, a nil search, not in record, not in search, a negative search, whatever you want to call it? Your task list can keep track of your search results. And I want you to keep track of the ones that don't pan out, because you want to know that you've already looked there. So I searched for variations of Teller and Kasten without success. That's a good start. Maybe I would want to say in, and then insert the name of the specific record collection that I looked for. And then I put on family search, because this will show up again in my final usage location. Unfortunately, it's a nil search, so I'm gonna add NIL at the beginning. Highlight, I searched for without success. Now, I can also highlight, and I wanna get all the letters. I'm not getting that first W, there we go. And then I can bold it, I can underline it, and I can italicize it, really make it stand out there. Once you're finished, go ahead and click save. Save saves it. This arrow takes you back to this form. So now you have status. What is the status of your task? So you remember how I had shown you that other people put open up here? Well, in status, is it a new item? Am I working in progress on this item? Have I completed it? Do I need to put it on hold? Is there a problem? Or do I need to cancel it? And then I'm going to put in the results why I'm canceling that task. So really great status terminology to use for where you are in your research project. So I'm gonna go ahead and say completed. I did a search, it didn't pan out. So the next thing you can do is choose what is the order in which you want to do your tasks. This will be helpful when you filter your tasks, and I'll show you that here in a moment. So let's say I want to do, it's about medium high. I kind of want to look for it. I really want to find that birth record first, and then I can get the marriage certificate second. Now the last field is great because let's say you want to keep track of correspondence. Well, you can keep track of correspondence in the tasks view as well. And all you would do is label that as correspondence. So what would the name be? Well, the name could be correspondence with Gertrude Ring. And then the start date, the first time you wrote to them or they reached out to you, the last time a letter was exchanged, and then they keep the dates open-ended. And then you can go through, do the high points in the letter because you're going to use that as a source somewhere else where you can put the full transcription. So that's what I would recommend if you're using it for correspondence. You can also say this is to do, and then if it's to done, you can make it research. I'm a little punny today, sorry about that. And then click OK. So now I have birth record for Helen Teller, marriage certificate for Helen Teller. Now, say you have more tasks on this list than I do. What you can do to filter out your results is you can click on filter results. And then you can filter by start date, only shows tasks with no start date, only show tasks with a date. You can filter by details, where it equals, and then you can put in some information or contains and put it for information. So let's take some time and talk about folders. So if we go over to this view and click on this button, we'll have the option to create a folder. Now your folder can be named anything you want. Maybe I'm gonna type in marriage proof for Helen Teller. A couple other examples could be Teller 4-Generation Project. Generation 1, Helen Teller, which I had already created. So maybe this is Generation 2, George Teller, Helen's father. You could also do Civil War service of George Teller, who, you see what I'm saying? Your project name needs to be something brief that encapsulates what you're trying to do. John Townley Brickwall, William Townsend's parentage. Get some ideas? And then in the folder description, if you are following quality research practices, this is where you would put your research objective to identify the spouse of Helen Teller and the date and place in which they wed, period. So you see, a great objective statement. What I would really like to do is add a task to this proof. So here's all of my tasks. Here is the generation one task, but I don't want that there. So what I want to do is add the marriage proof here, click on select existing, make that bigger, select existing. This is the marriage record that I found on Ancestry or the task associated with it, and click OK. And now I have it over here. Notice the generation one proof can have a birth and a marriage record, but if I'm just trying to look for marriage, I can have this record and anything else that talks about the marriage. So that's what's really great about these folders. You can use one item in multiple folders, or you can look at all of them at the same time. And since I don't have a lot in here, it's hard to see how that all flows. I hope that helps you start utilizing RootsMagic 8 to keep track of your tasks, your correspondence, and the success of your research. If you want to learn more about genealogy software, be sure to check the link above. And if you want to see the latest video from Family History Fanatics, check this one right here. If you have any more questions,